Hi guys, it's Big Al and welcome back to my Football Manager 2018 Journeyman Series with IFK Timra. Now since you guys have been last with me, this is the last game of the season. Let's have a quick look. So, where were we? So yous were with us for a cracking 1-0 victory against Pieta IF. Since then we went two games with a defeat. So we lost 2-1 to Solderhams and 3-2 to Valbo. Now, in the game against Valbo, we changed our formation halfway through the game because we were getting absolutely hammered. So we went to the wing-back formation. Now, we stuck with the wing-back formation. So then, in the next game, we won 2-0 against Bolinas. And then we went out and beat Bodens 3-0. Now, the league has ended. This is the last game of the season. We already have champions, which is Skellefteå. And it looks like Morton, on the last day of the season, if results go their way around them, they will win. They will physically get them second. As you can see, we're down here in ninth. If we win and these and Pieta and that lose, we could leapfrog these teams, depending on how many goals we can score. Because obviously there's a plus three difference between ourselves and Pieta, who are on 39 points. And if we win today, that would give us 39 points. So if we won 3-0, we would join them. They might stay above us due to head-to-heads. But either way, it's not a problem. So as you can see, it's the last game of the season. Don't know if I'm going to get my contract renewed. They haven't offered me one. So I may just find myself jobless after this game, even though I have achieved the target of mid-table. So today, let's go back and back again. And today, our team selection is this. So we got the 3-5-2 formation in place for the third and for our final game of the season with Shavin in goals, with the back three of Calderon, Svedberg and Lagergren. Tansey and Nahu playing as the wing backs, with Alvarez, Grunley, Bazuke, Abdul Jali and Karaman, who are both from my youth squad. Now Abdul Jali has scored in the last couple of games for us. And Karaman, this is his first game, last game of the season. Why not? The only reason why these guys were playing is because we got a load of injuries to our strikers, which are now all back, and they seem to be all fit. But today, especially Bergman. Bergman was out for three or four games there, so was Koopy. And if I remember correct, Alexton was injured as well for a couple of games. And as you can see, Abraham is still injured. So we've promoted all our under-19 player strikers to the team to try and do it. So as you can see here, we have worked the ball into the box, overlap and close down more. That's the only three instructions we have set up for this. And let's get stuck into the last game of the season. So as you can see, none of these two players have played this season because they're both from the youth squad. And I like to play youth players anyway, especially in lower league football. And we will see if we can pick up a final day win for you guys. That would be epic. Two wins in a row in the videos. Whoop, whoop. So let's get into the dressing room. They're playing a standard 4-4-2. And let's hand it over to the good old assistant. Yeah, Abdul Jali, he's been, no matter what I say, he seems to be absolutely delighted with it. So I think we're not all white. Yeah, we're in the all white and blue. Still haven't learned this team's kit, which is ridiculous. And Ostersund is in the red and white. And if we score straight from kickoff, that would be epic start to this game. But I can't see it. And there you go, keeper saved it. But a chance in the first 19 seconds of the game there, guys. Just what we wanted. Obviously, Bodin has scored. But as you can see, Ostersund are way above us in the league. Now, we did beat Bodin's the last game out, so Our main concern is Pieta and Harnosans and also Valbo. Because obviously if Valbo win, they could leapfrog us. 4, 5, 6. Maybe not. We'll be a point clear, I think, of them. So we need Pieta to lose. And we need Harmans to lose. And we need to win. Just to pump us up the table just slightly to confirm our mid-table finish. And then I might get a contract again. But already, like, Söderhamn, we can't catch her losing, so that's fine with me. We're 10 minutes in. Nothing exciting has happened, unfortunately. This is not what I'm used to. The last few games, it's been highlight after highlight. And there you go. Pieta are winning 1-0. Oh, they're playing Harnessans. Okay. Well, if Pieta win, that's good. So Harnessans are now ahead of us by 3 goals. So they're playing Pieta, who are 1-0 up. So if we can win, that would be nice for us. Because we could actually get up into that position. If they draw, a draw would maybe suit us. No. We'll finish 8th maximum if we can win today. But we need to win to get 8th maximum. And Valvo are now winning. As we get the highlight. Conchavin with the goal, with a free kick. Jali plays it back to Grunley. Back to Jali. Jali back to Grunley. Grunley, where are you going? Wrong way. He plays it out wide to Nuhu. Who cuts inside to Alvarez. Oh, great football. Nuhu back in the Alvarez. Oh, looks like we're just going to play around the edge of the box. They got 2 banks of 4 in front of us. Nuhu plays it in, but we've now lost it. And they can probably break on a counter-attack. As Baker plays a lovely looping ball over top. And Lederwall is in. And we are 1-0. No, he put it over the bar. Oh, I thought I'd just gone in the top corner. But say we're 1-0 down 20 minutes in. But we're not. Thankfully for that. Well, thankfully they didn't score there. But as you can see, Valvo are 1-0 up. They're now 1 point behind us. We have the better goal difference over them. So at least that's something in our favour. But the game's been pretty even, to be fair. Both teams have had 2 shots. We've had 1 on target. They haven't. But they're 5 counts higher and they have had more possession than we have. Which I am quite surprised at, considering they're playing a 4-4-2. I thought we might have been able to exploit them. Corner to us. Bazooka, the man who's been on fire in the last few games, crosses it in. No one gets on the end of it. Grunley. Alvarez. Saved by the keeper. Oh, it didn't go away. I thought it went down for the corner. Carman picks it up, but there's nobody over there to help him. And it should be a throw in. No, highlight's over. I would have loved to finish 7th, but I'll settle for 9th if that's where we're going to end up this season. I'll settle for it. Because we're against IFK Ostersund. Ostersund. And they are above us in the table. Where actually are they in the table? Are they 5th? Yeah, they're 5th in the table. So, you know, they've got 46 points. We're giving them a game here, which is nice to see. Unfortunately, not many highlights for you guys, which is kind of disappointing, especially considering it's the last game of the season. Oh, and the previous 2 games, there was lots and lots of highlights, which is just typical for whenever I record, huh? You guys don't get many highlights. Instead, you have to listen to me just talking and talking and talking. And there you go, Bowden are now 3-2 up. Well, that game's turned into be a classic. They were 2-0 up, the 2-8, now 3-2 up. It's the kind of game you want to be watching. Sorry, guys. We had that in our last game that you guys didn't get to see. And now they have a corner. Clark with it. Very English name, Clark. Unmarked and a goal. Oh, is this not copied over my tactics again for corners? That looks like the standard corners. And Perman just buries it. It is. Look. Yeah, that's not the tactic I have set up for corners. That is the default one. Going by the way everyone was stood there. 1 second, guys, while I just check my tactic. And we come on the counter-attack. Are we? We're back, guys. The tactics were fine, but that was a default layout. The way my team lined up, which I'm not happy with. That was a default lineout, so I have it set, and that's where he was standing. There was about, should have been 2 other players standing right in front and behind him, which you clearly seen in that clip, there wasn't. So I don't know why it hasn't used the tactics as set, which is kind of disappointing, because that's a goal from a corner, which we haven't conceded a goal from a corner in quite a while, to be fair. Now, we are 1-0 down here, which is not great. So, it looks like we will be finishing 9th this season. Unless they absolutely drum us by about 7 goals, then we'll be finishing 10th. But how things are standing, we're going to be finishing 9th. Which, I guess, is like mid-table-ish? Maybe not. So, Mills with a goal kick for them. It's not a bad full kick. We should win that. Well done, Calden. Bazooka. Carmen, come on, Jali, Oh, he was easily tackled, and they get the ball back. Now, will they spring a counter-attack again? No, Colden's there again. Grunley into Alvarez. Simple pass, Alvarez. It doesn't say pump it in the box. It says work it into box using the flanks. And here they come again. Leadwall plays it into Baker. Shot and a goal. Jesus Christ. Shocking. All out from a pump ball is not set. It's set to work the ball into the box. It doesn't say pump it in. And a good counter attack. And a very good finish, to be fair. Leadwall plays in a very good ball. Straight through the gap in the two centre backs. Nowhere near him. Keeper had no chance. And we are now 2-0 down. Well, this is not how I wanted the season to end, as a 2-0 defeat. But Bazooka's on 6.2. Could be 3-0 by half time here, which would be very devastating, to be honest. And we have cleared it, but it's gone straight back to them. And for some reason, they seem to be getting plenty of players in our box, which they shouldn't do, because we've got five defenders in there. It's amazing how quick this game has changed around. 6 shots to 3, 2 to 2, 11 fouls to 2, 54%. Now, obviously, like, I mean, we were winning on the shot count and that earlier on. We seemed to have the better play in the first 20 minutes. But now it seems to be just all Ostersund. And we just don't seem to have anything in response. Like, Bazooka, I've never seen him have a 6.1 in a long time. Even Calden's struggling. He's even struggling for fitness now. He's down to 71%, which is weird. But he's only on a 6.2. Didn't seem to turn up today. And I don't know why, because the atmosphere was pretty good going into this game with two wins in a row. Which is kind of worrying. Well, they're going to get shouted at now anyway. So, let's give them a good rollicking at halftime. Well, I'm just going to tell them I want to see a better performance second half. I'm not impressed. Let's make some changes as well. So, these are our worst two players. Have we got another centre back on the bench? No, we do not. And we don't have an attacking midfielder on the bench either. Alan. What are you doing? I guess we could put Bergman in. We could actually drop Carmen back. Can he play as a shadow striker? No. Fuck me, man. Well, that's just no good, is it? Great, so I've got no defenders on the bench, and I got no attacking midfielders on the bench. I could bring Oddmark in, actually. Bring Oddmark in for Bazooka, stuff it. I'll just have to keep an eye on Calden, and if the worst comes to worst, I can move Fenberg out and bring Capui into the centre back. Actually, tell you what, let's just take Calden out and put Capui in. I know he can't play there, but let's just do it anyway. And let's get the second half started. Oh, I should change it to attacking. We're 2-0 down, last day of the season. Double change. Let's go all out attack. We might as well. There's no point in not. And if they score 4 or 5, well, they score 4 or 5, but we might as well give them some type of a challenge this half. And straight from kickoff, they're looking dangerous now, which is not good for me because I didn't fancy them scoring straight from kickoff. Good challenge by Nahu, and that's it all over that part of it, thankfully. It's kind of disappointing for the finish 9th. I was hoping to get 8th. I had it all in my mind to finish 8th, but you know, we'll take it with it as it comes. This is only our half a season at our first journeyman team. Obviously, the contract runs out at the end of the season, which is obviously not at the our end of the season is today. But I know that they probably have a playoff game, and there'll be a couple, like another week. So if they let us go, they let us go. If they do, I'll then find another club, and we'll just start with another club, but we'll see what happens. If the keeper's on, we'll reshape the team for next season, because next season will be our last season with IFK Timra. I don't want to be going staying here forever, because A, they aren't giving me any coaching badges because they can't afford it, so they won't let me do any coaching. So I need to progress as well. So, and then goes Oddmark. Can he score the equal? Yes! Johan Oddmark pulls a goal back. And it's great play, as I wasn't even paying attention because I was too busy talking to you guys. Great football. Oddmark even was involved in the initial build-up. And Abdul Jali finds Grunley, who just plays a beautiful ball into that open gap. And Oddmark, which is what Bazooka was doing earlier on in the last few games, pops in there and bangs in a little goal. So as I said, guys, before I was nicely interrupted with a nice Oddmark goal, is IFK Timra's board will not give me any coaching badges, won't pay for it or anything else. They won't even give coaching badges out for their own coaches and all that are already here as well. So obviously I need to progress, so I can't be stuck at IFK Timra for more than a season and a half, to be fair, because we need to get our experience up and obviously try and get some coaching badges so we can start going to bigger clubs in like the first divisions and championships, because the aim of the game is to try and get as many trophies as we can and obviously improve ourselves as a manager and see if we can get a few more clubs up divisions and try and win the main leagues and the European Cups. It's Jamat Abdul Jali. Oh, good challenge. And they've cleared it, but oh no, I thought we were going to win that ball back, but nope, instead they play it in between the two centre backs again, and Baker's through and over came the right back, well, right centre back to cover up. They put pressure on him. So 60 minutes gone, it's 2-1. We've come back into this game slightly, still not as much as what I thought we would have came back into this game, to be honest. I thought we might have had a bit of a better chances against him. But obviously, Carmen, it's only his first game for us. I can't see him getting too many more games, to be fair. But I'll see once I go through it, I know what I want team-wise, what I need to improve this team. Obviously, there's a load of dead wood in this club as well. So over the summer, if I still have a contract, I'll be clearing this team out, dramatically clearing it out, and looking then to invest in some players from the division above who are too good for this division, maybe the division above or the division above that. Bring some of them in if we can get them, mainly on free transfers as well, if we can get them in and maybe make this team the team to beat next season, because they have a decent enough little build up here. Oh, we're giving it away in a stupid place again. And Lindelwald's in and he blasts it wide. They have a good starting build team here. So they should be able to build up bigger and make this club a lot stronger. Because, like, I mean, we got a decent goalkeeper and a decent 16-year-old midfielder. So if I could build a team around those two and then just try and get some decent defenders, a couple extra wing-backs, proper wing-backs, so that Tanzi and Nahu don't have to play wing back all the time, because they're right and left back naturals. They don't actually play wing backs. I'll request them to be retrained as wing backs for next season, and hopefully then we can get a couple of extra centre backs in to make it stronger. Get rid of Svenberg and probably get rid of Lagergreen and try and get two decent centre backs in to replace them, and a couple of youngsters to boost it up just so we have spares. But like, I mean, the rest of the team, well, there's not really anybody who stands out. Bazooka's done quite well, so I need an extra attacking midfielder. Oddmark looks like he can come in and do the job though, so maybe keep Oddmark and Bazooka as well, keep Grunley, keep the goalkeeper, and then work from there. Now who plays at the edge of the box? Kapui, what are you gonna do with it? Oddmark, oh, hit it into the box and it's went in the back of the net, but he's given the free. I'm guessing it was for offside. Well, guys, I'm going to put it on the overload to see if we can get this equaliser. Because since we went on attack, we've been the better team. So I'll put it on overload now. 10 minutes left of the game. We got a decent squad. We got a few, like, centre midfield is okay. attacking midfield pretty good, goalkeeper pretty good. It's just everywhere else. So if I can get rid of this dead wood, we could maybe get a decent team. And Abdul Jali hasn't been too bad, but Carman's in. Can he score? Oh, great save by Mills. No offense, I think Carman should have scored that one, to be honest. I might keep Jali because he scored quite a few goals. Grunley with the corner and easily defended, but Svenberg. And there it is, a man who I was just saying I should be getting rid of because he hasn't done anything all season. Pops up on his first game, actually, in the club, in the team, and pops up with a goal. And we have restored the game to being a draw. Excellent. That was a good finish, actually, to be fair, for a terrible centre-back. Absolutely terrible. Well, 8 minutes left, guys. I think we might be able to snick a winner, maybe, in this game. That would be epic way to end the season with a nice win, with being 2-0 down, coming back and winning 3-2. That would just be amazing. But I'll settle for a 2-2 draw, to be fair. We played quite well in this game in the second half. The first half, we started off the first 20 minutes with a stronger team and then just fell apart. Oh, and are they going to nick the win now? Just as I was saying, we should nick the win. Richards with the throw-in. A lot of English names in this team. Oh, Kongstaven saves it. There seems to be a lot of English names in that Osterstad team. But I've been trying to keep all the players from Scandinavia, you know what I mean? From Denmark, Norway, Sweden, you know, trying to keep all, so they speak pretty similar languages, so trying to keep it pretty similar. But if the English players can come over and do some jobs, I might sign a few English players in to bolster up the team, maybe a few players from Skybet 1 and Skybet 2, because they could play with ease in this division. I don't think we'll get championship players in this club, but I can say we get Skybet 1 players, which would probably make us a lot stronger team, and maybe the Spanish second division and things like that. But I don't want too many like outside of Scandinavia, because they've got a good pool here in Scandinavia. If I can get a couple more Norwegian, Finnish, Danish in, we'll be all right. Nafu, Carmen, Alvarez, we're in stoppage time. There's like 4 seconds left and we've won the ball back. And Jali, will we get a late goal? No, we're giving it away. It's out for a throw-in, and that's it. Thrilling second half finishes. IFK Timra 2, IFK Ostersund 2, and we finish 9th in the table. 1 point behind 8th, who drew 1 each by the looks of it. I didn't see any extra goals in the second half from that game. Plenty of extra goals in from us, of course, which is great. So as you can see, guys, that is us. We have finished our first season. I know it's only been half a season. Hopefully the board will give us a new contract for next season. If not, then we'll obviously start searching for our next club and we'll come back with the next series. But if they do continue on with it, I'll play the pre-season out and we'll come back for the first league game of the season. And then every 5 games, I'll bring out a video every 5th game because it's easier. If you guys want 2 games to see an episode, let me know. Comments in the comments box. Obviously, if you've enjoyed it, thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of our Football Manager content or anything else that we are now displaying on the channel. Plenty more stuff to come on the channel. So, guys, hit that subscribe button and get liking as much as you can. Thank you very much, guys. Have a good one. All the best. Bye.